Over the next few videos, we're going to go over using Angular with Django. What we're going to do is we're going to start out by setting up a basic Angular app and getting it actually working with Django. We're going to move on to how to display data from Angular, and then two separate ways to get data from the back end to the front end. We're going to start with some Ajax, and then we're going to move on to using Angular's ng resource, which is a super common library that people use to deal with data. We are not going to go over how to use Angular itself. This is just enough to get you started with a couple of the intricacies of how to use it with Django. Once you watch this first video, you'll be able to go on and follow some tutorials on how to get started with Angular. After you get through all of the videos, you'll be able to go on and do more advanced tutorials and start actually making your full single page applications using AngularJS or editing ones that are already existing. So with that, to start, the first thing that we have is a very basic Django project. If we'll do an ls of our project folder, you'll see we have Angular demo, which is the root of our project. We have our database, we have a home app, we have a manage.py, a media static, and templates. All very basic Django stuff that we're used to seeing every day. If we look at our views, you'll see we have an index view and it inherits from template view. So we're setting the template name to be base.html, which is in our root templates folder. From there, if we look at our base.html file, you'll see it's all very basic HTML. At the very top, we're loading in our static files template tags. And then if we'll scroll down, you'll see that we're importing jQuery and we're also importing Angular to be used. Finally, we're using the static template tag to bring in our main.js file, which is where our JavaScript and Angular code that we write is going to live so that it can be used on the page. Other than that, there's nothing else that's going on our site. We're not really going to be doing any database access or anything like that for this video. It's just strictly getting stuff on a static page. So let's go ahead and look at our main.js file. And as you can see, we have three lines of code. This is very super basic. Our first line is we're creating an Angular module and we're calling it app. This is going to kind of be our application that we use with Django. We're calling it demo app just to give it a name that we can reference in our HTML. The next thing we're doing is we're creating a controller called demo controller, and we're going to be able to use the scope object, which is a very common thing that you use with Angular so that you can get data back and forth and do many other things to be able to hold data across the current scope, hence the name of the controller that you're using when you're interacting with a page. So if we look at our HTML again, first thing we're going to do is we're going to go to our body tag and we're going to add ng app equals demo app. This is saying, hey, for this body area, we're going to use the Angular module of demo app. And so everything available in demo app, we can now use inside of this page. If we do not set this, then we won't have access to any of our Angular stuff. Now we want to go ahead and try to use our demo controller. In there, we're going to go down to our div and we're going to do ng controller equals demo controller. And so now this div that we have set the demo controller to is going to have access to anything that's available in our demo controller that we create. And we're going to add some code to our demo controller here in a moment. First, let's go ahead and just add some HTML. We're going to have our div of data. This is where we're going to actually put some information. And then we also have a button that we've created, and we're adding the save method on ng-click. So now whenever we click on this button, it's going to go ahead and call the function that we're going to set in our app controller. And then the purpose of what this actually div is going to do is we're just going to click on it a few times, click on this button, and it's going to count up the number of times that we've clicked the button. So let's go ahead and jump back over to our controller. We're going to use our scope variable and we're going to set a variable on it called num, and we're going to set it to 0 because we've clicked 0 times. Then we're going to go ahead and create a scope called save so that we can call the save function over in our HTML. And then we're going to set that div over there with a class of data. And every time we click on it, it's going to set the HTML to click and output the scope.num variable so that we can see how many times we've actually clicked on it. And then finally, after it shows that, we're going to iterate the scope.num by 1. So we're going to do our plus equals 1. So now every time we click on it, it's going to iterate up the number of times that we've clicked on the button. So let's go ahead and see that in action. If we'll open up in our browser and refresh the page, you can see we have the click button. And if we click it, the first click brings up our click information, and then we'll just click it a few times. And you can see that it's up to 8 clicks that we've clicked it without doing any page refreshes. So this shows that we've actually used our Angular demo app. We've used our controller of DemoController, and we've actually successfully used a variable that we've set on scope and used a function that we've set on scope. And then doing the jQuery way of getting our element is one way that you can actually display data on the screen. And in the next video, we're going to go over how to actually display data from a template perspective in your templates from Angular. So with that, I hope you join me next time for a continuation of our Angular code.